بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه وسلم، أما بعد. الله سبحانه وتعالى and the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم both praise knowledge, seeking knowledge, the ulama, the place of the scholars, and ignorance or jahil are things madhmum in the sharia, yani things that are disapproved of and things that are considered it's negative in the sharia. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says fi kitabihi al-kareem, هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ إِنَّمَا يَتَذَكَّرُوا أُولَى الْأَلْبَابِ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Zumar, هَلْ يَسْتَوِيَ الَّذِينَ يَعْلَمُونَ وَالَّذِينَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. Are the ones who know and understand, who possess knowledge, and those people who do not know, meaning those people who are ignorant, are they the same? Verily, those people, those possessors of knowledge, meaning the ulama, they are the ones who reflect or think about, who know this and have the awareness because of their ilm and their fiqh. وقال سبحانه وتعالى في كتاب الكريم يرفع الله الذين آمنوا منكم والذين أوتوا العلم درجات. Allah تبارك وتعالى says in the Quran as well, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has raised those who believe from amongst you and those who were given knowledge, درجات, meaning that they are raised, they have a higher status. They're raised in the dunya, as Shaykh bin Uthaymeen mentions, and in the akhirah, they will be raised according to what they were given and how they practiced it. And did they give da'wah? And were they patient upon that path? As Shaykh Muhammad ibn Abdul Wahhab rahimahullah ta'ala mentions in his treatise, his famous treatise, Usul al-Thalatha, in the beginning, he says, I'lam rahimakullah, annahu yajibu alayna ta'allama arba'a masail al-ula al-ilm. He says, verily, it's an obligation upon us, four things, knowledge. And then he describes what is knowledge. Al-ilm, وَهُوَ مَعْرُوفَةَ اللَّهُ مَعْرُوفَةَ النَّبِيُّ وَمَعْرُوفَةَ الدِّينَ الْإِسْلَامِ بِيَدِّلَّهُ. And it is knowing Allah. It is knowing his messenger alayhi salatu wasalam, and knowing the religion of Islam with the textual proofs. Then he mentions Surah Al-Asr. He says, "Wal Asr inna al-insan," he says, "a'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim, bismillahir rahmanir rahim. Wal Asr inna al-insana lafi khusr illa alladhina amanu wa 'amilus salihati wa tawasaw bil haqqi wa tawasaw bis sabr." Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions those same maratib, those same levels, as Sheikh Muhammad mentioned the levels, and the dalil is in the ayat where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, by the time, he swears by the time, verily mankind is in a loss. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, mankind is a loss. Then he makes istithna, illa alladhina amanu, except those who believe. So belief, to believe in Allah, to believe in his angels, to believe in his books, that takes ilm, that takes knowledge. We have to have knowledge about who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. We don't get this by just thinking, as some of the Ahl al-Bid'ah believe, that we can't just reflect upon the creation and then we're going to know who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. No, we have to know from the Quran. We have to know from ta'lim, from understanding the Quran and reading the Quran, reading Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's about his al-asma'i wa sifat from kitabillah wa sunnatu rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And we have to know about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala's rububiyyah. We can gain some knowledge from reflecting on the creation, but we can't just make seclusion and believe that we're going to know and understand who Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is. But we know rather from the Quran and the Sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So this comes from knowledge and practicing that knowledge and understanding that knowledge and calling to that knowledge, making da'wah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala says, fi kitab, في كتابه الكريم: قل هذه سبيلي أدعو إلى الله على بصيرة أنا ومن اتبعني وسبحان الله وما أنا من المشركين. الله تبارك وتعالى says في كتاب الكريم to the Prophet صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وسلم, he says, قل, say, this is my path. Call to Allah. So what is our da'wah? Our da'wah is to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Call to Allah ala basira. The shahid is ala basira, that we have knowledge, that we have understanding, that we have wisdom in calling to Allah with beautiful preaching and insight, reflecting on His ayats and practicing it. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, all throughout the Quran, tells us the importance of Ahl al-Ilm, the people of knowledge. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala also mentions that we should ask the people of knowledge. Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala says, في كتاب الكريم, وَسَأَلْ أَهْلِ ذِكْرٍ كُنْتُمْ لَا تَعْلَمُونَ. Ask the people of knowledge if you don't know. So if you don't know and understand an issue, if you don't know and understand about something, ask the people of knowledge. Those people have more knowledge than you. If you're able, because you are blessed with the Arabic language, or you at least have access to scholars that speak English, then ask them. Ask those people of knowledge. If not, other than them, you could go to the students of knowledge and the du'at and your imams and your masajid. Ask those people. Those people have more knowledge than you. And if you don't have access to any of those, then ask someone who has more knowledge than you. They may perhaps have that knowledge or have access to that knowledge. And in this day and age, we have some of the good of the internet that we can obtain this knowledge and access to the scholars, unlike other times in history. So that shows us some of the ayats, the signs of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the verses of Allah tabaraka wa ta'ala, which illustrate for us the importance of knowledge. What about from the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? From the sunnah of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, we have many ahadith. For example, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, إِذَا مَاتَ الْإِنسَانِ إِنْ قَطَعَ الْعَمَلُهُ إِلَّا مِنْ ثَلَاثِ صَدَكَ جَارِيَةَ الْعِلْمِ يَنْتَفَعْ بِهِ وَوَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ أو وَلَدٍ صَالِحٍ يَدْعُ لَهُ رواه مسلم. In the hadith in Sahih Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ said, when a person dies, his deeds cease except three. He said, first, sadaqa jariya, meaning the continuous charity. So, for example, if someone spends on a masjid or waqf, you know, maybe they buy Qur'ans for a markaz al-ilm or markaz al-sunnah, buy books for students of knowledge or whatever, something that's a continuous charity that when you die, that charity still, you still receive reward from it. The second one, which is the importance for us, al-ilm, ilm yantafa' bi, knowledge that the people benefit from. So if a person is given some knowledge, maybe they are given just a little bit of knowledge and they have the ability to translate. So they can translate material and people benefit when that person is in their grave. That person is still getting ajr and the people are benefiting from his or her knowledge. Or that person is a du'at. They go out and they give da'wah for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And they've left some of that knowledge for the people. They left students or something, so talib al-ilm or what have you, and they left students behind. Those students pass on their knowledge, and they pass on their knowledge. Maybe some of their students write books and notes from that person who died. This is also ilm yantafa bi, or they're a person who writes books. Whatever the situation is, that they have left behind knowledge. And the third one is the person who has righteous children, and they supplicate for him or her on their behalf after they've passed. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions also in the Kitab al-Kareem, في سورة آل عمران, قال سبحانه شهد الله أنه لا إله إلا هو والملائكة وأولي العلم قائم بالقسط. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala witnesses أنه لا إله إلا هو, that there is no God worthy of worship except Him, والملائكة, and the angels also bear witness, وَأُولِ الْعِلْمِ, and those who are given ilm, who are given knowledge, meaning the ulama, the scholars, قَائِمٍ بِالْقِسْطِ, with they also are adhering to justice, that they have justice, that they contain justice, they're fair and just. So this shows also the importance. The main important point is that the makan, the position of the people of knowledge, وَأُولِ الْعِلْمِ قَائِمِ بِالْقِسْطِ, and the people of knowledge who are just and they bear witness to the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is the position of Ahl al-Ilm, and there's so many ayats. And the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, مَنْ يُرِدَ اللَّهُ بِهِ خَيْرًا يَفَقَهُ فِي الدِّينِ. Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the religion. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam also said, In the same hadith, من يرد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين وإنما أنا قاسم والله يعطي ولن تزال هذه الأمة قائمة على الأمر الله لا يضرهم من خالفهم حتى يأتيهم أمر الله. رواه البخاري. In this hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in the beginning he said, من يرد الله به خيرا يفقه في الدين. Whenever Allah wants good for a person, He gives him understanding of the religion. The ulama also explained that the person who is not given ilm, not given knowledge, meaning they stay in their same status, they're not benefiting in their life and benefiting with their time and benefiting in knowledge, that's a sign that Allah doesn't want good for them. Because to stay jahil of who Allah is and the sunnah of His Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Islamic religion in general, this is something sinful, and it is in fact a pathetic state. May Allah protect us from it. وَعِيَاذِ بِاللَّهِ مِنْ ذَلِكَ. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala mentions also in the Quran, in Surah Al-Baqarah, I believe, or it's Ali Imran, qala subhanahu وَأَعُوذُ بِاللَّهِ إِنْ أَكُونَ مِنَ الْجَاهِلِينَ. And I seek refuge from being one of the jahileen, being one of the people of ignorance. And that shows us what? That is something to seek refuge from being ignorant, from staying in a status of ignorant. And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said in that hadith that this ummah won't cease to be on the command, following the commands of Allah or the commandment of Allah, and no one will harm them, even if they differ from them, until the hour is established. So that shows us that knowledge is important, and knowledge is what distinguishes this ummah. And those people of knowledge, they have so many benefits. The point I wanted to make here, the reason I wanted to establish that, also the Prophet ﷺ said, وَمَنْ سَلَكَ طَرِيقًا يَلْتَلْمِسُهُ بِهِ عِلْمٍ سَهَلَ اللَّهُ لَهُ طَرِيقًا إِلَى الْجَنَّةِ. Whoever traverses the path of knowledge, then Allah will make easy for him the path of Jannah. And the Salaf al-Saleh, they used to, Ridwan Allahi alayhim, they used to refer to the person who seeks knowledge, Talib al-Ilm, Talib al-Jannah. The person who is seeking knowledge is in fact the person who is seeking Jannah. That should be our purpose in seeking knowledge. The reason I want to mention this, because someone asked me recently in reference to certain things about speaking about Ahl al-Bid'ah, about people who are known for many mistakes and that have some mistakes in which takes them from the fold of Ahl al-Sunnah. So they, in fact, they are from people of Ahl al-Bid'ah, or they have fallen into Bid'ah. They asked me about so-and-so, and you know, what do I know about him? And I've seen, and the individual said, I've seen on the internet different statements about this particular individual. So I answered by saying, leave that. Leave that. Be aware of their mistakes, especially on the internet. You'll find lies and you'll find truths. But if you find from a well-known person that this person should be warned against, then stay away from that individual. But as far as busying yourself with seeking out this person's mistakes, it's sufficient to know that this person has these mukhalifat, these mistakes, and to leave them. But not to spend time, hours and hours, especially if you yourself may not have the ability to really properly seek the knowledge, or you haven't become well grounded in the books of ilm and the Salaf al-Saleh, the methodology of the Salaf al-Saleh, and following Kitabillah wa Sunnatu Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, it would be better for you and your soul to atlub al-ilm. And this is the advice of the ulama. This is what the ulama constantly tell us. I'll give this as a faida. When I first went, over 12 years ago, we went to Damaj, a place in Yemen, in the north of Yemen. And a particular brother, alhamdulillah, he was the translator for us, because none of us knew Arabic at that time, or we all had different levels and we all were very limited. Some had more knowledge and some had less. So a particular brother, he translated for us. We were able to have a sitting with Sheikh Bukhbil bin Hadi Al-Wadi'i, Allah yarhamuhu, Sheikhana Al-Lama Al-Muhaddith in Yemen. And so the Sheikhs told us three advices that I can recall. He said, learn the Quran, memorize Quran. He said, learn the Arabic language. And he said, and leave off involving yourself in wasting your time by speaking about issues you have no knowledge about, or كثرة قيل وقال. And this comes from a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, to speak and to follow the faults of people and say excessive speech. I heard this, I saw this on the internet, this site said this and this site said this about so and so and so and so. Okay, this is the golden advice the Sheikh told us. And this comes from a hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is the best advice. So this is where the Sheikh got that advice, that if you want to attain knowledge, it's going to conflict by seeking out the mistakes and so forth of individuals. That doesn't mean being aware of mistakes. But what I'm saying is wasting your time involving yourself in issues that have no benefit. If it doesn't benefit your iman, then that's a clear sign to leave it. The second point I want to make, which leads into it, is the mistakes of people who are known for Ahl Sunnah. Some of the du'at, some of the imams, some of the talabat al-ilm that are well known. There are some websites that busy you with their mistakes. They say so-and-so has been married 30 times. So-and-so has divorced so many women and committed zina this many times. This one has women have come to the masjid with DNA things. This one has is known for doing evil things to the women. This one is these things are of no benefit to you. Why do I say that? Because a lot of times these things are unfounded. So then if these people who have made these websites are spreading this evil, then they're getting sin. And then you, for reading this and involving yourself and spreading it, I heard about so-and-so, they did this, and it's unfounded, then you're responsible for ghibah and namima. And we know the hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the hadith, many hadith of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam that tell us about ghibah and backbiting. And we know that that's one of the reasons for namima, is one of the reasons for the adhab qabr, for being receiving punishment in the grave. As the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, marra nabi, as it was said about the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, marra nabi sallallahu alaihi wasallam ala qabrain faqala innahu faqal sallallahu alaihi wasallam innahuma yu'adhiban wama yu'adhiban fi kabir amma ahaduhuma fakana la yastatiru min al-bawl wama akharu fakana yamshi bin namima. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the shahid of the hadith, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was walking by two graves, and he said that verily they're being punished for something grave, but that the people think is not a big thing. As for one of them, he used to not make proper istinja, not clean himself properly when he urinated. As for the second one, he used to make namima, meaning carrying the tails of individuals in order to spread evil. And that shows that that namima is one of the reasons people are punished in the graves. The third point I wanted to make, that the particular brother, may Allah preserve him, asked about the term medkhalis. Now I don't know if he read this on websites, if this is something he's sincere about, or he's making empty hand of me, he wants to know what my position is about this, I don't know. And we assume the best, that he saw this and he wants to really know. As far as what I know about the term medkhalis, it is in reference to some of our mashayikh, like Allama Rabi bin Hadi, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, Sheikh Muhammad bin Hadi, Hafidhullah Ta'ala, and Allama Zayd bin Madkhali, Hafidhullah Ta'ala. These are some of our ulama, and that they all belong to the tribe Madkhali. They have the same name, Madkhali. And of course, they're students. So this is in reference to some of the Hizbis. They refer to those ulama, they try to distinguish those ulama from what some of the great scholars of this time who preceded them, and some of their scholars like Ibn Baz, Al-Albani, Sheikh Muqbil, and others, that what they were upon. So they try to separate them and say they are on something other than them. So they refer to them as madkhalis, because they, those three ulama especially that I mentioned, they specialize and they tend to speak about Ahl al-Bid'ah and make clear for us Ahl al-Bid'ah, and they are well versed in those issues. And so due to that fact, they gain a lot of enemies. A lot of people, especially the Hizbis and people who are spoken about, they dislike them. That doesn't mean, as the Prophet ﷺ said, "Kullu ibn Adam khata wa khayran khata'ina tawabun." That doesn't mean that any of the ulama are free from mistakes, or any of the talibat al-ilm, or any individuals are free from mistakes. No, everyone has mistakes. "Kullu ibn Adam khata." Everyone, all the children of Adam, they make mistakes. And the best of those are those who repent. So the point being here is that this laqab, this way of speaking about those ulama in a negative way and referring to them as madkhalis in a negative form, madkhalis, and that's their tribe. Yes, they're madkhalis. But we know that the Hizbiyin, they spend a lot of time speaking about those great scholars and anyone who speaks about Ahl al-Bid'ah, when in fact that's from the religion. But however, that's not for everyone. That's not for the layman on the street to start speaking about so-and-so. So-and-so is like this, and so-and-so is like this. So-and-so is this, you know, and labeling people with no knowledge. No, that is for the talibat al-ilm. That is for the scholars, and not for everyone. Everyone should not involve themselves in those matters. But in fact, we need to focus ourselves on seeking knowledge and coming closer to our Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's what you have to question yourself. Whenever you come across these issues, ask yourself, are they bringing you closer to Allah, or are they bringing you further to Allah, further from Allah? Are they involving bid'ah? Are they involving backbiting and namima and so forth? No. And as we said, those are our scholars. But I don't refer to myself as a madkhali or a follower of madkhali. La. I call myself a follower of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, from Ahl Sunnati wal Jama'ah, following Kitabillah, wa Sunnatu Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and the understanding of the Salaf as-Salih, the Ijma'a Salaf, ala Aqidah, wa Minhaj, wa Fiqh, and so forth. And this is what we refer to. And this is what we go back to. And we ask Allah the Almighty to accept our good and forgive our evil. Anything that I said was correct was from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Anything that I said was incorrect was from myself and the shaitan. Wa sallallahu wa sallam ala nabiyyina Muhammad wa ala alihi wa sahbihi wa sallam. Subhanaka lahumma wa bihamdika. Ashhadu an la ilaha illa ant. Astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayk.